you enjoy your day at the festival.
Oh, yeah. Huzzah!
Oh, you sound like they did.
Your final day at the festival.
Aww.
But there's still more comedy and entertainment and music.
Huzzah!
Would you like to see some more?
Yes!
Can we introduce ourselves?
Yes, I was trying to get the audience at a fever pitch.
Oh, fever pitch.
Are you in a fever pitch?
Hi! Woo!
Charles Brandon versus the world. All right, so now that you're in a fever pitch,
woo!
We can begin tonight's musical finale.
Huzzah!
I'd like to introduce my co-host, Cruella DeVille.
Huzzah!
Woo! I simply worship her. And my co-host, the Big Bad Wolf.
Ladies, Cardinal Claudio.
Woo!
And the best dark co-host ever to grace the stage at this or any other Renaissance festival. Whatever. Now, Lady Eileen Dover.
Woo!
We have tonight for you some wondrous mashups. Tonight, we're going to mix a little bit of comedy with music. May I introduce to you Comedia Mania and the Two Bands.
Woo!
Oh no, Mania Mania has also joined the purveyors.
Yeah.
I know. Do you like my colors?
They're terrifying because now there's a band with us.
They have a band.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we thought it appropriate to bring you some quality musical theater here today with the purveyors, with Comedia Mania. So, prepare yourself for something a little bit spooky.
Ooh.
A little bit cheery.
Yeah.
A little bit adventurous.
Yeah.
Like a date with Kobe Bryant. All right. Thank you. You're welcome.
The pop laugh.
Yes. That was for him. We'll be telling you the story of Little Red Riding Hood as told by the Travails and Comedia Mania.
Woo!
Once upon a time, in a beautiful little cottage was a girl named Little Red and her mother, who hated her.
Ugh, Little Red, you're so annoying and obnoxious.
So she sent her to the woods.
Here you go. Go to your grandmother's house and give her this basket full of food.
But it's all the way through the dark, scary woods.
And?
So she slapped her and told her to go, anyways. And she moved on and she danced merrily through the woods. She thought she was safe from all of these lunatics. That's when things got a little bit spooky and arrived our villain, the Big Bad Wolf. He was sexy and dashing and villainous. I dropped epidote.
What's in your basket?
Oh, well, I've got lots of delicious treats.
That's awkward. So he ran away to go check on her grandmother. After stealing her ID, I don't know, we're moving on. When finally, she got lost in the woods, running on a merry little way, when we arrived at the grandmother's house. And she was sassy and voluptuous. She had very sexy varicose veins, which she called love maps. You never know where they might take you. When finally the wolf arrived to murder her, very dramatically, but she was very attracted to him,
woo!
And she chased him through the woods.
Ah!
Get away from me, you praying mantis woman! And things happened. Ask your parents.
Where's my grandmother?
She's
tied up up in the middle of the woods to a tree.
What?
It wasn't my idea! But now I'm gonna kill you.
So you went to go kill him, but all of a sudden, that's when a hero arrived. It was one of the...
My name is Piggy O'Montoya. You killed my father, my brother, my friend.
And just then, he distracted the pig.
Hey, oh, there's a spider in a web making a message to you.
Oh, wait, what's it say? Look behind
you. Oh! And just before our house was there. Oh, my God. And that was going to kill Little Red Riding Hood. But another hero arrived, a much superior hero.
Well, you know, I do believe there is something going on tonight. A coronation. Did you hear
that? I heard nothing of it whatsoever.
Well, before we do that, may we get their majesties on the stage?
My lord and lady. My lord and lady. There's
lady.
Only one of them. My lords and ladies, pray rise for their most royal majesties, King Henry and Queen Catherine.
God save
the king!
My good people, my beloved people, thank you! Be seated! Did you enjoy your festival day? We are so pleased that so many of you could come this day and throughout our festival. Truly, more than new friends, to us you are our new family. And here, in our new beautiful home of Norwichshire, we would have a new coronation, if thou wouldst. Where is the Lady Fritzy? The Duchess of Norwich, sire.
I fear, my lord, that she has appeared and disappeared as the witch she is.
Indeed, terrified. If she should be spied, please do grab her forth. Hold on to a bit of salt on her broom. Should keep her in place for the long time that we need. In the meanwhile, we would hereby announce that there shall be a new Lord and Lady of the Realm. Every year, we here at the Connecticut Renaissance Fair do like to give notice and give recognition to those who have done great service to our kingdom, our realm, our friends, and our family. This year, we are most pleased to announce that the Lord and Lady of the Realm, who will be elevated to the title of Duke and Duchess of Bristol, shall be Gary and Louisa Gladue. Let it be known that on this, the 19th day of October, in the year of our Lord, we'll call it 2013, there was a misprint. Within this village of Norwichshire, these loyal friends of the Connecticut Renaissance Fair have been raised in peerage. Henceforth, they shall be known and recognized as the Duke and Duchess of Bristolshire in service to His Majesty.
Oh my goodness.
Excellent!
Hip hip!
Huzzah!
Hip hip!
Huzzah!
Hip hip!
Huzzah!
And when she is found, let it be known that Fritzy Batchelder shall be announced as this loyal friend of the Connecticut Renaissance Fair Ambassador of the Year!
We are most honored, Your Majesty. This is our fair family. This is our home fair. And we thank you so much, because if it was not for all of you, we could not do what we love to do. Thank you very much, everyone.
Huzzah!
Even with more voice than that.
That's right. Get off the stage. Oh, my.
Majesty.
Majesty.
Yes, indeed. Oh, wait, there's coronations in this.
My jewel. Love jewel.
My lord, please take to one knee.
Excellent, well.
There it is.
Excellent.
Thank you so much.
Huzzah! And a final cry, hip hip!
Huzzah! Woo-hoo-hoo! As it should be. Now, let's get back to some fun. Thank you very much, everyone. Now, I have heard that there is a new singing.
Is this some sort of segue you're trying
yes,
to work
it is. In? When yeah. one is a duchess, one knows everything that goes on. You know. Now, I heard they are very popular with the ladies. So, it is with my pleasure. The Lords of Adventure. William Shakespeare. The sexy Lord Mayor. Look at the swagger. He's a legend in his own mind.
I've got him hit right under here.
Where's Joe?
Protective family.
Your Majesty, if we may, we would be proud to do a little encore of one of your own songs.
Oh, I hope it's Green Sleeves.
Yes, it is. Green Sleeves, Your Majesty, we would like to do it for you now.
Alas, I love you too. Throw me off discourteously, for I have loved you far. Delighted in your company, your vows you broke in like my heart. Though I remain a world apart, my heart remains in captivity.
My lady,
Green Sleeves was all my joy.
My lady,
Green Sleeves was my delight.
My lady,
Green Sleeves was my heart of gold. But lady, Green Sleeves, if you intend us to stay, it does the more enrapture me. And even though I still remain a lover in captivity. Green Sleeves was all my joy. Green Sleeves was my delight. Green Sleeves was my heart of gold. But Lady Green Sleeves, now I can see that we're falling apart from the way we used to be.
Yeah.
No matter the distance I want you to be, I'll be wearing my sleeves of green. When I see you, oh my lady,
I have no words.
You know, there are some times you can't top an act, and other times you just don't want to.
But you don't. That's okay.
But rarely do you get both like that.
I'm thinking maybe we need something serious for just a moment.
Serious, yes. Yes. That's what we need.
Did Shakespeare get his shirt back on?
No.
Avert your eyes. Apparently, I have been told, see, when you're Duchess, you know these things.
Oh,
there has been a mystery.
We know nothing with her now.
Right. There has been a mystery.
Only for a year.
Mystery, I tell you, in this shire. Lady Mandrake, do you know anything about this? Wolfie wants to know.
Must I French
her? There has been a mystery in the village today. And the Mandrake's mystery. And I am Lady Mandrake. Luckily, we have had the best detectives in the kingdom working on the case. They have spent the day gathering clues and interviewing suspects. All those that have participated in the Mandrake's mystery, please step forward.
Thank heavens, I was so worried. For the bill that has been stolen, if I cannot find it and pay it from our treasury, then the village of Norwichshire will be bankrupted, and truly we shall never again have our affair.
Oh.
I know it would suck so bad.
And the answer to today's Mandrake's mystery is the bill was stolen by none other than King Louis.
What?
The dragon held free.
I'm a Louis. Honestly, if I'd known you were going to do that, I wouldn't have even given the cue.
They've been waiting 5 weekends for that.
Why would you have stolen the bill we worked so hard to form an alliance and marry off my
There's sister? A very good explanation for this.
You see,
I had such a great day at your festival that when I get back to my beloved France, I am hoping to do our own festival. We're going to call it Euro Renaissance Fair. It's going to be funded by Lord Disney. It'll be a hit, I swear it.
I can't imagine
but
what
I
could
got
go wrong.
Stuck on the exchange rates from the English crown to the French crown.
Oh, yeah, well, there's a whole thing with the Franks,
yeah,
and then you gotta talk to the Germans.
But here you go.
Oh, excellent, well, let me just see that. Oh, well, that's unpleasant. So glad I got this now. Yes,
you know, I'm just going to give this to the Queen. Okay,
there you go. Thank you, Louis, I'm so glad that you fessed up. Must have worked hard to get that bill here. All right, up. Now, good lords and ladies, take to one knee if thou wilt, Wilfrid.
Sir.
We can't have any loose ends. Hey, what I mean to say is, since you have done such a great service to us by allowing us to continue to have our beloved Connecticut Renaissance Fair, I do dub thee as knights of this realm in the name of God, St. Michael, and St. George. Arise, you up, newly dubbed knights. Hip, hip.
Huzzah!
Hip, hip.
Huzzah!
Hip, hip.
Huzzah!
Lady Mandrake will present you with certificates of merit as you exit the stage to the hullabaloo of our assembly. That is some good hullabaloo.
We surely do have a hullabaloo, Eileen, because I have you not got tired yet of seeing 1,600 people on stage?
Never.
Then, my lords and ladies, let us reintroduce to you the Trouvères and our spectacular court dancers.
Thank you.
I'll look at it.
Are we in your way?
No.
No, no, of course not.
But do mind your face.
Mind your face. How often she hears that.
My lords and ladies, a favorite dance of mine has been passed down across the pond from the French and brought to our court. We do this in honor of his eminence. It was an inspiration for him, and he is an inspiration for all of us. So in his honor, we dance La Volta!
Something.
We are a little bit of color.
A little bit, perhaps.
We need
a
pop of color.
Pink.
Pink.
And yellow.
Yellow.
And blue.
Possibly blue.
And yes. They're here only this weekend.
They're here only this weekend.
My lords and ladies, the three, the only, the spectacular Limey Bird.
Thank you for making us feel so welcome. We love you all. Thank you.
is that we dedicate this song to the Vixens.
To the Vixens.
We need everybody up here.
We won't be satisfied till the support for the stage collapse.
Yeah, we're hoping to get back next year.
So, once upon a time we had to have real jobs.
Oh, I know.
Hard to believe. So this song's about some of the older jobs that we've had over the years. It's very serious. We need a moment to prepare. Are you ready, sisters?
He used to work in London town in a merchant store. I thought I did a pretty good job, but I don't work there anymore.
Sing that again, girls.
I used to work in London town in a merchant store.
In a merchant store.
Thought I did a pretty good job, but I don't work there anymore. Go, Bonnie.
A woman came in for a drink one day. I asked her what kind she'd prefer. Liquor, she said. So liquor I did, and I don't work there anymore.
Well, good night, everybody!
I used to work in London town, in a merchant store.
In a merchant store.
But I did a pretty good job, but I don't work there anymore.
Go, Charity! A man came in for a chicken one day. I asked him what kind he preferred. Pull it, he said. So pull it I did, and I don't work there anymore. It's really because I got the carpal tunnel.
I used to work in London town, in a merchant store.
In a merchant store.
But I did a pretty good job, but I don't work there anymore.
Go, Faith.
A man came in for some hardware one day. I asked him what kind he preferred. Nails, he said. So nail him I did.
Your Majesty, I don't know if you flashing a child.
Well, even for the clergy to see it that way. I'm sorry, too soon. I'm sorry.
Hey, Faye.
What?
What if they had screws?
Oh, they're in the back. I used to work in London town in a merchant store.
In a merchant store.
Thought I did a pretty good job, but I don't work there anymore. A man came in for a bird one day. We asked him what kind he'd prefer. Swallow, he said. So swallow we did. And we don't work there anymore.
Wait, we got promoted. Oh,
yeah. I got the corner office. Oh,
yeah. What'd you get, Charity?
Oh, I got a pearl necklace, but it's really tight sometimes. It makes me choke. Go.
He's working London town. In a merchant store.
In a merchant store. Shared by the Connecticut Renaissance.
Well, I have no idea.
Do we need culture? Now you have no words?
Maybe
culture. Wait, we're still going on?
One more. We have time. We have what time? Mr. Shakespeare, final words. Oh.
Shakespeare, you may blow me kisses. So, lords and ladies, I can only thank you for making me feel so very, very welcome as I have been here 4 of the 5 weeks of the Connecticut Renaissance Fair. If you have any complaints, though, please do send them down to Florida.
Yes.
That's where the Home Office is.
Yes. And, okay,
but lords and ladies, I would like to give you a reading from my new book. Tis entitled Star Wars, Verily a New Hope. Hit it! It is a period of civil war. The spaceships of the rebels striking swift from base unseen have gained victory o'er the cruel galactic empire. Now adrift, amidst the battle, rebel spies prevailed, installed the plans to a space station vast, whose powerful beams will later be unveiled, and crush a planet, 'tis the Death Star blast. Pursued by Agent Sinister and Cold, now Princess Leia to her home doth flee, delivering plans and a new hope. They hold of bringing freedom to the galaxy. In time so long ago begins our play in a star-crossed galaxy far,
far away.
Wonderful thou art!
God save the Connecticut Renaissance Fair!
I can think of nothing else for us to say, but with your kind leave, merry meet,
merry part, and merry meet again to the gates.
To welcome in the mail, for summer is a-coming.
Did you ever sign it?
I did.
Okay, good.
Read the inscription.
Okay.
Last chance to ruin your time.
Jolly Rumpelo, we were up long before the day, oh, to welcome in the summer, to welcome in the mail. For summer is a-coming, and winter's gone away.
Robin Hood and Little John have both gone to the harrow. We will always be going to hunt the fucking harrow.
Hal and Joe, Jolly Rumpelo, we were up long before the mail, to welcome in the summer, to welcome in the mail. Summer is a coming, winter's gone away. And the curse is raging, the curse has been degraded. We have celebrated the coming of the spring. Oh, Hal and Joe, Jolly Rumpelo, we were up long before the day, oh, to welcome in the summer. Welcome in the mail, summer is a-coming, the winter's one more time. Hal and Joe, Jolly Rumpelo, we were up long before the day, to welcome in the summer, welcome in.
Summer is a-coming,
and winter's gone away.